Shalom. Before I start, let me give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah Korash, divine honors to the elders and apostles, great millstone, peace, blessings, and salutations to all the elect Akim, walk wathim, learning and teaching in truth and sincerity. This is going to be another video through the Spirit, dealing with this clip from the elder Ayathun. All right, I'm going to be getting a couple screenshots and pictures too, also dealing with a video that the elder brother Kazak did. Out of the state that I always forget, I believe Mississippi. All right, the fact that Esau, Edom, double E, A, ultimately it's all a curse from the Heavenly Father. But Esau understood that demasculating the men and effeminizing the men would give them power over our nation. And it is a plan that he put into full swing, which is why now here in America and throughout many different places of the world, you have women running a show. You have men who are in a weaker form and fashion, and you have women that are in a dominant form and fashion. All right, and ultimately Esau, he created that dynamic between the Israelite man and the woman so he can have better control of us. All right, so you know, for the brethren, we have to and the scriptures teach us the best. You know, you got people out on YouTube that do MGTOW and you know, manly videos. I got a whole playlist called Manly Man. All right, but the scriptures teach us best how to be masculine, how to be an upright man, how to be honest, how to have courage and faith and honesty and integrity. All right. And Esau doesn't want men, especially Israelite men, having those things. So he put us at variance with our women. All right. So for you Israelite sisters that are out there, if you want to truly be in line, the very best thing you can do is always be in a submissive position to any man. All right. Not just talking about, sexually, or you know, just your husband, but just understanding the fact that a man is over you, period. It is never in your best interest to argue with any man, all right, even a random bum off the street. It's never in your interest to try to assort any type of authority over your over a man. All right, now if you're at, you know, you're working a job, it is what it is. You know, let's say you're a damn manager somewhere, you got to do what you got to do, but it does not benefit a woman, nor is it wise to always be in an advantageous position over a man. Because when all these, when this society collapses, every man you screwed over is going to remember that, and they're going to come looking for you. All right, so let's let this play. We're going to get some scriptures. All right, let's get it rolling.
And I ask you to look in the mirror and ask yourselves, what are you doing in this time of great challenge?
To break down how they had to get women to see men as the enemy. And again, she went on to say, we'll use blacks because they're the weakest group, they're the poorest group. The most
Slaki, whenever he says blacks, just think of all the Israelites, so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. All right, I'm going to leave the link for this. You know, y'all go check it out. It's good stuff.
Institutionalized group at that time, just being 70 years or so out of slavery in the 1860s, she said, what we'll do is just like we had the old system of the women were brought into the house. You're getting the big secret of feminism right now. Just like the house slave was always a woman and the men were kept out in the barn and weren't allowed to read or write, we're going to set women up as the minders of society again. There's actually Roman handbooks on this from 2000.
And so he decided to switch the position between a man and a woman, all right, for his own benefit. And as he's about to quote, they did this in Rome. So what does this show you? That shows you that this beast today is the same one from back then. All right, they pulled out the same tactics. And whenever you set women up to the top of the society falls.
Years ago, where they talk about with white slaves at that time, mainly from Western Europe, you bring in the slaves, you kill a couple of the men in front of the women, you even kill some of the kids, and you tell the women, it's your job to keep these men in line, or we're going to kill all of you. And they found that women, believing they were protecting people, would become incredible oppressors and tattletales over the men. And then within a few generations, they started enjoying the oppression and didn't even do it to, quote, protect the men.
And that's the situation we're in now. They are now enjoying it. All right, women were set up for a cause, and now they've begin to enjoy it. All right, the sloot walk, feminism, you know, all those things. Let's get some scriptures real quick. Let's get this one. All right, this is all a big scam. Esau doesn't care about women's rights or none of that. This is a mirage to keep our people down. All right, let me get this. Let me do this. Slovakia, I should have had it already ready. Yep. Jeremiah 31:22, it says, "How long wilt thou go about, O thou backsliding daughter? For the Lord hath created a new thing in the earth, a woman shall compass a man." And that's the situation that we're dealing with. All right, especially here in the Americas. You know, and this is a very, you have to, as an Israelite man, you have to actively remind yourself to be masculine, to do things that men of the Lord would do, and not do things the way that your mother raised you to do them. All right, not an insult to anybody's mother. You know, she did the best with you that she could, but she was working in a flawed system, so you would have been taught flawed ideologies. All right, don't ever hit a woman. Lay your mama, you know, all that, all that shit. You know, just be loud and proud and arguing. You know, all that stuff. That's not what men are supposed to be doing. And Esau knows that. That's why he shook up the system so he can have better control. And now we're in a situation where things are spiraling out of control. All right, let me let this go some more.
And I was reading about how they retranslated those Roman documents from Latin into French and then into English by the 1820s or so in the sugarcane plantations. I'm giving you history here. Heavy truth, folks. The sugarcane plantations of the Caribbean, they would bring a ship of slaves in. Already half of them on average from Africa would have died in the trip over because they didn't really feed them from Africa. And they'd get them off the coffin ship, and then they would kill the most well-spoken, obvious leader, just from body language and things, of the blacks that was alive in front of the women. They'd beat their brains out, or they would hang them. And they'd tell the women, "We're going to kill all your male children if you don't keep everybody in line. Is that understood?" And they found the women would do whatever they were told. So that's where you get the mammy in all the Three Stooges movies and stuff, bossing the black guys around, and in all the old movies that are still, you know, representing what really happened in history, where the black woman is in charge, and she's got the big, you know, big mammy outfit on, Aunt Jemima, and she's in there telling those black men, "You do what you're told." In fact, in this culture, it got so dominant that my father...
All right, yeah, so that's about it. You know, so that's why we're dealing with this situation that we now have before us. This is all a trick and a plan. Esau, Edom did not care about our women liberating them. It was all a big joke. All right, let me get this, these couple screenshots here. Now, this is one right here that I had found, you know, scrolling through YouTube. It says, "The children of millennial women will be the most effed up in kids." Oh, Slovakia, the children of millennial women will be the most effed up kids in American history. Compound, meaning combined, feminism and slut culture, plus head meds and widespread social media addiction equals a volcanic disaster. And that's what we're dealing with here. That's why, hey, this place is going the way of the dinosaurs. A society has been created that cannot exist. All right. From the times of old, who was out there on the battlefield? Who was out there building and constructing? Who was out there paving the way? And then who would be in the home keeping the children in order? Getting the meals cooked? You know, setting up those type of things. When you reverse that order, you breed chaos, all right? You breed disaster, which is many people who come up to the camp, it's just not for them. They're not going to get it. The Lord, if Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai didn't put a certain spirit in them that at some point they would be able to shake off that feminine American energy, they're not going to get it. No matter what, a nigga can be 7'8", you know, and be a big hoe. This place, Esau Edom deliberately made sure that the minds of the people would be broken. And once again, he didn't do women's rights because he cared. He did that to gain better control, to separate men and women so he can control them. All right, not because he cares about the sisters. All right, and I got another one over here just to show you. So now that women are allowed to be whatever they want, do whatever they want, now look at their mindset, or one of them. This is a sister. It says a effing bitch. That's what she named herself, because she know what she is, a bee, and she doesn't care. It says, promoting weight loss is actually fat phobic, and y'all show your fat phobia under tweets that tell it like it is. There is nothing wrong with being fat. You can be healthy and fat. Before and after pictures are fat phobic. Losing weight and improved health are actually not intertwined. And now that is an outright and a complete lie. All right. Literally, being fat is the is having access stored energy on your body that you're not using, because you're eating more food than energy you are consuming on a day-to-day basis. All right. So at the definition of the word itself, it is impossible to be fully healthy. All right. And we understand, you know, as you get older, you put on weight, you know, it gets to the point where you can't continue to exercise at the way that you used to when you were younger. But this type of mindset, everyone is allowed to give in to all their pleasures, no accountability. And if you don't like it, you know, F you, you're just being a hater. All right. And, you know, absolutely crazy. This girl crazy. You know, she got all types of probably self-confident issues, you know, somewhere stink, but she doesn't care. Esau told her that just be the way that you are. And the way that men and women naturally are is wicked, except we have these scriptures. All right. So let's come back. Let's get this. Now we're going to go to Esther. All right. You can't flip this order. This is an order ordained of the Heavenly Father. And even the heathens understand this. All right. Now this is going to be, we're going to start at verse 10. I don't feel like reading. Let me see. I want to get straight to the point because I got one more I want to show. Esther 1 and 10, it says on this. Now, you had Ahasuerus, the king, all right? It tells you up here in verse 1, he was about to throw a big party, basically. It says, on the seventh day, when the heart of the king was merry with wine, he commanded Mehuman, Biztha, Harbona, Bigtha, and Abakta, Zether, and Carcass, the seven chamberlains that served in the presence of Ahasuerus, the king, to bring Vashti the queen before the king with the crown royal, to show the people and the princes her beauty, for she was fair to look on. But the queen Vashti refused to come at the king's commandment by his chamberlains. Therefore was the king very wroth, and his anger burned in him. Then the king said to the wise men which knew the times, for so was the king's manner toward all that knew the law and judgment. So the king, now this is a king, y'all. Hey, us average people walking the street, we're not considered kings. So, you know, if the king can get done like this, any one of us can get done like this. But this was an extreme form of disrespect. That's why it says he was very wroth and his anger burned into him. All right. And he being a king, him being a man, his men being under him, men, what counsel did they have and what did they understand? Verse 16, it says, and Memucan answered before the king and the princes, Vashti the queen hath not done wrong to the king only, but also to all the princes and to all the people that are in the provinces of the king Ahasuerus. For this deed of the queen shall come abroad unto all women, so that they shall despise their husbands in their eyes. When it shall be reported, the king Ahasuerus commanded Vashti the queen to be brought in before him, but she came not. Likewise shall the ladies of Persia and Media say this day unto all the king's princes, which have heard of the deed of the queen, thus shall there arise too much contempt and wrath. All right, and that's what we're seeing in this world, too much contempt and wrath. Why? Because the order is overthrown, and this is something they understood back then. They said, damn, wait a minute. If the queen is bucking up to her man, all the women and all the empire are going to buck up to their men, and it's going to be chaos in these streets. It's going to be Bloody Mary everywhere. All right, so if that kingdom back then couldn't handle it, this place now sure as hell can't handle it, because Esau Edom is worse than the Persians and the Medes. And that's why we're seeing and going through some of the things that we're seeing and going through. And this is all a plan deliberately put in place by Esau Edom. All right. So we have to, these people are under an active brainwashing program. All right. So you have to deal accordingly. All right. And this is, I'm going to let this clip play. You know, this shit right here is crazy. You know, go check this video. I'm gonna just fast forward to the clip of the girl talking. Let me see. And then I may get one more scripture. Or I may get one more scripture before I even let it play. Let me see. Yep, so I'm gonna let it play.
Unto me, and these hast thou.
So now that our women and women, you know, worldwide have been given this authority and this power, what are the things that they want to do with it? Let's see.
Sacrificed unto them to be devoured. Is this of thy whoredoms a small matter?
Hey, and once again, you know, hey, this ain't no woman bashing video. This ain't no woman hating video. You know, the elder put up this clip, you know, so I'm just doing my, my take on it. You know, this is serious business. We got to know what type of world we're living in.
Guys, like, do you not see what's happening? Georgia's literally about to pass a bill, or they already passed.
I just want to say, all I see is them big ass eyebrows.
Bill, where soon as a fetus has a heartbeat and it's detected, you can't get an abortion. Do you not realize that the earliest you can detect a pregnancy is at 4 to 6 weeks, I believe. The heart starts beating by week 3. I haven't looked at the facts, but the heartbeat can be detected way earlier than you guys are realizing. Like, I don't think you guys are realizing how big of a fucking deal this is, and like how terrifying this is for women around the world. Like, you guys don't realize that, like, my body anatomy is being taken from me. If I don't want a fucking child in me, I should not have to have that fucking child in me. And this should not be up for debate. This shouldn't be something that legislators in a House seat that don't even have a womb or ovaries should be able to decide. We have to fix this, guys. This is a really big deal. And I don't understand why we're not talking about
it. Thou hast to slip.
Look, man, she got slobber all in her mouth, turning red and shit. You know, she's being an activist for the actual murder of children. You know, this is how bad things are gotten. She thinks she's in the right. She's campaigning murdering babies, which is why there's been, I forget the numbers. I forget how many abortions from when they began up until now, but they're in the millions. They're in the 20s, 30s, or sums of millions of Israelite babies that have been aborted, all right? So this is what happens when the tables are turned. This is why the tables have to go back right side up. She's sitting there with them Rock Lee bushy brow, you know, eyebrows, you know. I think she in Hot Atlanta, Georgia, you know, so no reason why she want to get abortion so she can keep hitting the nightclubs, you know, every week. This is why this place isn't going to continue on. All right, I'm going to get this last one, and that'll be it, actually. Where is it at? Yep. Tobit 4:13, it says, "Now therefore, my son, love thy brethren, and despise not in thy heart thy brethren, the sons and daughters of thy people, and not taking a wife of them. For in pride is destruction and much trouble, and in lewdness is decay and great want. For lewdness is the mother of famine." All right, and so I'm bringing out the fact that lewdness, all right, wickedness, all types of abominable acts bring its famine, which is what ultimately the fall and the decline of a whole civilization. All right, and these idiots, he did the same. Look at this crazy chick, man. He did the same thing back in Rome, and he's doing it again. So inevitably, he's gonna fall. All right, in a similar form and fashion. You know, so that's about it. I just wanted to get this in. You know, this ain't no woman hating bashing video. Just highlighting the fact that this way that we're living was properly set up by E. And so in the kingdom, it's going to go back to its proper order. All right. So all this stuff is going to be thrown out the window. You know, so look at her, you know, looking crazy. All right. You know, I'm going to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh Shai, Bashim, Rakakurash, the honors to the elders and apostles, the great millstone, peace, blessings, and salutations to all the elect Akim, Wakwatim, learning and teaching in truth and sincerity. And I'm going to say Shalom.